앉겠죠? អង្គជួយជម្រះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមនាការហើយមុននឹងបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនាការថ្ងៃនេះអង្គជម្រះសូមជម្រាបជូនដំណឹងដល់ភាគីនៃក្នុងរឿងក្តីសុខសុភីទាំងអស់ថានៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនាការថ្ងៃនេះអវត្តមានជាក្រុមយុវតារាដែលជាក្រុមជាតិដែលគាត់មានទុរៈចាំបាច់គាត់មិនអាចចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនាការបាន បន្ទាប់ពីយើងខ្ញុំបានពិគ្រោះយោបល់ជាមួយនឹងបណ្ដាជាក្រុមពេញសិទ្ធិនៃអង្គជំរះថ្លាត្បូងយើងបានសម្រេចតែងតាំងលោកជាក្រុមធូមនីដែលជាជាក្រុមបំរុងខាងភាគីជាតិជំនួសកន្លែងជាក្រុមយុវតារាដែលបានអវត្តមានរហូតដល់ពេលណាដែលលោកជាក្រុមយុវតារាមានវត្តមាននិងមានលទ្ធភាពអាចបំពេញការងារក្នុងការចូលរួមក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនាការនៅអង្គជំនុំជំរះថ្លាត្បូងវិញបានការសម្រេចនេះដោយផ្អែកតាម បទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធានចិត្តប្រមួន4នៃវិធានផ្ទៃក្នុងអង្គជំរះវិសាមញ្ញក្នុងតុលាការកម្ពុជាទូស្រីសកលវិទ្យាលោករីការអំពីស្ថានភាពវត្តមានអវត្តមានភាគីនិងបុគ្គលដែលអង្គជំរះអញ្ជើញចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសមនាការថ្ងៃនេះសូមគ្រប់លោកធាន
គ្រប់ភាគីទាំងអស់នៃរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានលើកលែងតែជនជាប់ចោតអៀងសេរីមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រៅបន្ទប់សមនាការនេះដោយជនជាប់ចោតបានស្នើសុំអ្នកបងសិទ្ធតាមរយៈមេធាវីរបស់ខ្លួនក្នុងការចូលរួមដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមនាការដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទប់សមនាការនេះលិខិតអ្នកបងសិទ្ធរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតបានប្រកល់ដល់កឡាមជីរួចហើយដោយឡែកសាក្សីបំរុងដែលត្រូវមកដល់សក្ខីកម្មបន្ទាប់ពីសាក្សី
សាសរុននេះគឺសាក្សី TC WB780នឹងមានវត្តមាននៅម៉ោង10:30នាទីព្រឹកនេះសាក្សីរូបនេះបានធ្វើសម្បត្តិនៅចំពោះមុខអ្នកតាដំបងដៃកាលពីម្សិលមិញអរគុណផ្ដល់ឯកសារឲ្យខ្ញុំ
អង្គជំរះថ្លាត្បូងបានទទួលពាក្យសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតអៀងធារីចុះថ្ងៃទី 7 ខែមិថុនាឆ្នាំ 2012 តាមរយៈមេធាវីការពារក្តីបកគាត់សូមលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមក្នុងសកម្មភាពដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនេះដោយគាត់សូមនៅបន្តតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីចម្ងាយតាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍សម្រាប់រយៈពេលដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពេញមួយថ្ងៃនេះដោយមូលហេតុបញ្ហាសុខភាពមិនអាចអង្គុយតាមដានស្ដាប់ ក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពដែលផ្ទាល់បានអង្គជំរះយល់ឃើញថាពេលនេះជនជាប់ចោតអៀងសេរីបានសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធមានវត្តមានក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពដែលផ្ទាល់តែគាត់មានលទ្ធភាពអាចតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្រោមសាលសកម្មភាពនេះតាមរយៈឧបករណ៍សោទស្សន៍នឹងអាចសម្រួលទំនាក់ទំនងរវាងគាត់ជាមួយនឹងក្រុមមេធាវីរបស់គាត់បានផង អង្គជំរះសម្រេចយល់ព្រមតាមពាក្យសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតអៀងសេរីដែលបានស្នើសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនេះឲ្យគាត់នៅតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្រោមសាលសកម្មភាពនេះតាមរយៈឧបករណ៍សោទស្សន៍សម្រាប់រយៈពេលដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពេញមួយថ្ងៃនេះប្រកបឲ្យផ្នែកសោទស្សន៍ជាប់ប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍សម្រាប់ជនជាប់ចោតអៀងស រុនសុស្ដីលោកសៅទរុនយ៉ាងម៉េចទៅលោកសៅទរុនសុខភាពនៅថ្ងៃនេះល្អប្រសើរទេ
បាទសុខភាពខ្ញុំថ្ងៃនេះខ្ញុំកុំចាស់ចូលខ្លួនដែរខ្ញុំសុំធ្វើតែមកព្រឹកបាទ
បាទអរគុណដែលលោកបានផ្ដល់ព័ត៌មាននេះមកអង្គជំនះដើម្បីអង្គជំនះមានមូលដ្ឋាននៅក្នុងការបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពដូច្នេះភាគីដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនៅក្នុងរឿងក្តីជ្រាបហើយអង្គជំនះបានជម្រាបជូនអំពីលទ្ធភាពនៃកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពនៅចុងសប្តាហ៍នេះ ือในทั้งนี้ให้นังสัปดาห์กร้อยได้หลัดเพียบนังอายทเวชลักษณีระเวียงสะใสสะเดือดร้อนให้นังสะใสเดือดเบียนรหัสนิยม TCW ใบรอยมือเพย์เบย์โดยมูลเหตุปัญหาเวชะเฮริเอชะระบบโลกสะเดือดร้อนให้นังปัญหาสกปรกเพียบก่อนยังคือยังนังอายจะดำเนินการมีหลัดเพียบดำเนินการฉลาดคือนี้ดำไปบรรทุกทานตะเพียบสกปรกเพียบประกอบทำไมเอาก็มีลาตะเพียบหนึ่งสกปรกเพียบซ้อมละมอมอาดอสักไข่กำจุนดอกยมเรียบานมาเจอประตอยมเรียสมประตอปิตกาจุนตือดำนางสาบริญญาทำไมบรรทอการตั้งสมรดังดาวจุบุษสะใสสมจี
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, members of the bench. Good morning, Mr. Witness, Mrs. Sosrun. When we stopped yesterday, we were talking about the trip that you and Chun took where you flew to Phnom Penh after Kampun, the member or deputy secretary of Sector 105, had killed.The sector secretary Lang, and we had talked about a meeting that you had with Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, and Sun Sen about those events, and in which you were asked to take over from Lang as sector secretary. When you were in Phnom Penh.Mr. Witness, did you visit the location where Lang and Kampun had died? And where was it? Where was it that this had happened?
Had can look at the line,
What did you see when you went to the location where Lang and Kampun had died?
Dal Lang hai nung Kampun ban slap no, lok ban khoe yai kla na ti no.
Bat khom khoe ke bang han tha dek teah lan muoy pa hel pa veng ma hat. Nung ke vai ta lang ruoch.คำพูดบางคนแองเข้มเคยกรอบเคลียร์อันหนึ่งทวีบทวีนั่นคือปีกรอบ
When how long were you in Phnom Penh before you returned to Mondulkiri?
อ๋อยะเปลบนาเดลมนลูกตลอดตมดลกิริวิง
ว่าคุณน่าจะมังไงคุณตลอดตัวมันต้องกรีบิง
And when you returned, did you bring with you the ashes of Secretary Lang?
อาทิตย์ที่รุกอชังรบบลังเชียเตยตะลิขาสระตัวจิมวยเต้ลิขาดมบอนตัวจิมวยเต้
บาดคุณบานยอเถียดนึงเตาเตาจูนอ้อยบองโปนเกเถบุญบาด
who is it that had given you the ashes of Lang to bring back to
Mandal Kiri?
បាទខ្ញុំឃើញគេយកមកឲ្យពួកគេនេះប្រចាំការនៅភ្នំពេញ
Were you also given the ashes of Kampun, the person who had killed
Pang?
Was it Pol Pot who gave you Lang's ashes?
Chien nea bokop oi ke yok athithiet Lang mok pokul oi lok rư ko nea na?
Panha nung khiom at sikol te khoen ta ke nea pacham ka nung yo athithiet nung oi khiom ma.
To ask you a few more questions about the meeting that you had with Pol Pot, Nguyen Che, and Son Sen while you were in Phnom Penh. Given that one member of the Sector 105 Committee, Kampun, had just killed the Sector Secretary, did they ask you any questions about Kampun and why he may have killed Lang? Were they angry or were they concerned about the loyalty of cadres in Mandalkiri region, given what had just happened? Now, when you flew to Phnom Penh to meet with the leaders, were you allowed to bring a gun or weapons with you on the plane? At this meeting that you had with Pol Pot, Nguyen Che, and Son Sen, was there any discussion about how it was that Kampun had gotten a gun? At this meeting with Pol Pot, Nguyen Che, and Son Sen, did they ask you for your views on whether Kampun was a traitor and whether there were other people who may have been working with him? Did they ask you anything about persons back in Mandalkiri who were related or connected to Kampun?
I couldn't get you a day, but...
Mr. Witness, after the killing of Lang and your meeting with Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, and Son Sen, were there arrests of cadres from the K-16 Commerce Office for which Kampun had been responsible?
Kampun Chea Pertien Chea Likha Nui Ti Nuk Te?
At Mien Te Bat.
Mr. President, I would like to read at this time and ask a question from document E3/367, which is the first interview of the witness by the co-investigating judges, at Khmer ERN 00251440, English ERN 00278697, and French ERN 00486013. And we put that up on the screen too with your permission. Mr. Witness, in your first interview with the co-investigating judges, you made the following statement. Quote, after the death of Ta Lang, I knew that the commerce cadres were arrested. Was that a correct and truthful statement?
What?
And did the arrests of the commerce cadres that occurred after the death of Ta Lang, did those arrests include Chun, the sector commerce chairman who had traveled with you to Phnom Penh after Kampun had killed Lang? And Mr. Witness, were you not directly informed by Pol Pot at one point that Chun had been called to Phnom Penh for re-education? What do you know about the disappearance of
Chun?
Mr. President, I would like at this time to ask the witness about an excerpt from what was his third interview with the co-investigating judges, which is document E3/384 at Khmer page 00345904, English page 00348373, and French ERN 00354237, and I'd like to put that on the screen as well with your permission.
បង្ហាញឯកសារលើអេក្រង់ផងដែរបាទ
អរខ្ញុំអនុញ្ញាត
Mr. Witness, in your interview with the co-investigating judges, you made the following statement, quote, I received a telegram directly from Pol Pot telling me that 10 days earlier, Chun had been called in for re-education and correction in Phnom Penh. Do you confirm that this is an accurate statement, Mr. Salsaroon?
ចម្លើយត្រឹមត្រូវរបស់លោកដែរឬទេលោកសាក់សី
បាទជាត្រឹមត្រូវគេហាត់ខ្ញុំអត់ដឹង
មីស្ទ័រប្រេសីដិន
សាប់ពេញលោកប្រធាន
S21prisoner list
យើងខ្ញុំមានបញ្ជ
ីអ្នកទោសអស់ prisoners who entered on the 23rd បញ្ជីអ្នកទោស1977ចុះថ្ងៃទី which is document D175/3.31 which records over 140 cadres from Mandalkiri sector 105 and division 920 who entered S21 on the same day the 23rd of November 1977 including Pan Khon alias Chun and at least 12 female cadres from the K-16 Commerce Office in Mandalkiri. I would like to use this document with the witness simply to refresh his recollection of the timing of these arrests and the identity of the persons who were arrested from Mandalkiri and sent to S21 following the death of Lang. If I may proceed, I will display the, would like to display the document on the screen, but I will simply ask questions of the witness as to the timing of when these arrests occurred.
If I may proceed. If I may proceed, I will simply ask questions of the witness.
អរជំរាបអនុញ្ញាត
មីស្ទ័រវីតនេសវីហាប់អេរេកឺដ
សំណួរ
ហឺ S21
យើងមានកំណត់ត្រាឯកសារមកពីស21ដែលជាអល់បង្ហាញ
23 of November 1977
so late in the year 1977គឺចុងឆ្នាំ77នោះChun,
also known as Pan Khon, the person who had traveled with you to Phnom Penh to meet with the leaders there, entered S21. He is, for the record, he is number 128 on this list. As I just told the judges,The list also identifies 12 female cadres from K-16, the Sector Commerce Office that we talked about yesterday, and that he told us that was under the control of Kham Khun. There are 12 female cadres who also entered S21 on the 23rd of November 1971, and also included on this list of the people arrested from Mandalkiri and sent to S21 was the wife of former Konek District Secretary Spy, the person you told us yesterday who had shot your two in-laws. Her name is Sikorn, alias Bar Lee, and she's number 129 on that list. Now, given your testimony that Chun had accompanied you on your trip to Phnom Penh after the death of Lang, does this refresh your recollection that the date on which Lang was killed and the date of your and Chun's trip to Phnom Penh was before the 23rd of November 1977?
បាទគឺខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេកាល77ហ្នឹងគឺខ្ញុំនៅស្រុកនៅឡើយទេខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងគេចាប់ពីណាពីណាជូនមកសូមទេអត់ដឹងហ្នឹងគឺខ្ញុំអត់យល់អត់ដឹងសោះអាហ្នឹងខ្ញុំសូមបដិសេធ
Well, Mr. Sausaroon, is it possible your memory, it's been a long time, is it possible your memory of the exact dates is incorrect and that it was somewhat earlier that Lang was killed and you and Chun went to Phnom Penh? Is it possible that your memory of the dates may be incorrect?
ឲ្យលោកចាំជាក់លាក់គ្រាន់ថាតើការដែលឡាងស្លាប់នឹងមុនពេលនឹងឬពេលណា
បាទឡាងស្លាប់គឺឆ្នាំ1978ថាជូនអ្នកទោះអ្នកអីនឹងតាំងពី77គឺខ្ញុំអត់យល់ទេអត់យល់អត់ដឹងសោះខ្ញុំអត់មានការពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅរឿងចាប់មនុស្សអីទេបាទ
The question I'd like to put to you, Mr. Witness, is who made the decision to arrest Chun and the other cadres from the Sector Commerce Office who were sent to S-21 on the 23rd of November 1977? Was it you, the person who had just been put in charge?Of the sector by Pol Pot, or had you been told, did you receive an order from the leaders that people associated with Kham Phuon were to be arrested and sent to S-21? Can you tell us that?
21ឬក៏លោកបានដឹងលើខ្លួនឯងពីរឿងនឹងតើលោកអាចប្រាប់ខ្ញុំនឹងតុលាការបានទេពីរឿងនេះ
បាទខ្ញុំអត់យល់ទេយើងរកឃើញហាតហាបាត់ថាបាត់គឺម្នាក់ម្នាក់គឺចេះតែភ័យចេះតែព្រួយបាទខ្ញុំអត់យល
់ Did you believe that Chun was a traitor who should be arrested?
ជួនគឺជាជួនក្បត់ដែលត្រូវតែអង្គការចាប់ខ្លួនទេ
អត់យល់ទេមិនដឹងថាក្បត់មិនបត់ខ្ញុំអត់យល់សោះបញ្ហានេះ
Did you know the female cadres who worked at K-16 the Sector Commerce Office?
ដែលធ្វើការនៅក16ជាមន្ទីរពាណិជ្ជកម្មតំបន់ដែរឬទេ
អត់ស្គាល់ចាបាទ
Did the Sector 105 chief have the authority to order that arrested persons in the sector be sent to Phnom Penh?
បញ្ជាឲ្យគេចាប់កម្មាភិបាលទាំងអស់នោះឲ្យបញ្ជូនពួកគេមកភ្នំពេញដែរឬទេ?
អត់យល់ពីប្រុសខ្ញុំនៅស្រុកក្របខ័ណ្ឌគេតំបន់ខ្ញុំអត់យល់កិច្ចការគេខ្ញុំអត់យល់ស្រាប់ខ្ញុំយល់តែការងារខ្ញុំក្នុងស្រុកតែមួយគាត់បាទ
Mr. President, I would like to read now again from the first OCIJ interview of the witness, which is E3/367 at Khmer page 00251441, English ERN 00278697, and French ERN 00486013. And we would also put that on the screen with your permission.
ហើយសូមអនុញ្ញាតបង្ហាញឯកសារនេះនៅលើអេក្រង់ផងដែរបាទ
អរជំរាបអនុញ្ញាត
Mr. Witness, in your first statement to the investigating judges, you said, made the following statement, quote, I knew that a number of detainees were transferred to Phnom Penh, but I did not know to which destinations. But it was ordered by Ankar via
Hassan.
Can you confirm that this was a truthful statement?
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
Who were the detainees who had been transferred to Phnom Penh? How did you become aware that detainees had been transferred from Mondulkiri to Phnom Penh? Now, in your statement, you said that the transfer was ordered by Ankar via Tassan. Can you remind us who Tassan was?
Tassan was the president
of the country.
The person you referred to here as Tassan, Mr. Witness, was that the Secretary of Division 920? Is that who Tassan was?
Man.
And this is the same person that you told us yesterday when Pol Pot asked you to take charge of Sector 15. This is the person that Pol Pot told you could assist you in the sector. Is that right? When you came back to Mondulkiri after your meeting with Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, and Son Sen, did you have a meeting with Tassan where he had a list of people from Mondulkiri sector who were to be arrested? Mr. President, we would again like to read from the first interview of this witness by the co-investigating judges, which is E3/367, and the year-end pages in this case are Khmer 00251440 through 251441, English ERN 00278697, and French ERN 00486013. And we'd like to put that on the screen
again.
That's correct, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, in your statement to the co-investigating judges, you said as follows, quote, Tassan from Division 920 came to the meeting with Ta Supia and me. He personally spoke about that arrest, for example, the arrest of Net Ta. Tassan already held the list, and I could not refuse. Can you confirm today that the statement you made to the investigating judges was a truthful statement?
Yes, Mr. President, that is the statement I
made to the investigating judges.
When did this meeting between you, the sector military chief, Tasopia, and Tassan take place? When was this meeting in relation to the time that you returned from to Mandalay from your trip to Phnom Penh? Do you remember where it was that you met with Ta Supia and Tassan? Do you remember how many names were on the list that Ta San had? How many people were on that list?
And
the person that you mentioned in your statement named Net Ta, can you tell us who that was?
Net Ta nung ta chien na da luk aich prab ban te
bat khom Net Tha nung khom doy at at chao yol at yol le dang khom.
Do you recall that Net Tha was the had been the deputy chief of the economics unit under Kham Phun? I'd now like to turn to a different subject, Mr. Witness, which is reports, including telegrams that you sent to Phnom Penh in 1978. And Do you remember in your interviews with the investigating judges being shown and asked about a number of telegrams that you had sent to the leaders in Phnom Penh? The first of those telegrams, Mr. Sasaruun, which is document E3/248, is dated the 1st of January 1978. And I will get to that document in a bit, but what I first wanted to ask you is, does that refresh your recollection that as of the 1st of January 1978, you were sending written reports or telegrams to the leaders in Phnom Penh?
បាទខ្ញុំនឹកអត់ឃើញទេពីព្រោះខ្ញុំបាត់ការចងចាំដូចខ្ញុំជម្រាបខាងលើតាំងពីឈឺមកបាត់និយាយហើយក៏តិចមុខភ្លេចក្រោយបាទ
Why don't we start with some general questions about how you sent telegrams reporting on the sector, the procedure by which you did that. Can you tell us, did you type the telegrams or did you handwrite them? How was it that the telegrams were prepared that were then sent to the leaders in Phnom Penh?
មេដឹកនាំនៅទីក្រុងភ្នំពេញនោះតើលោកសរសេរផ្ទាល់ដែរក៏វាយអង់គ្លេសលេខ
បាទអានឹងគឺខាខាគេគេអ្នកសរសេរបាទខ្ញុំអស
Mr. President, if I can make a reference, read from the third interview by the investigating judges of this witness, which is E3/384 at Khmer ERN 00345905, English ERN 00348374 and French ERN 00354238. And we'd like to put that on the screen also.
ខ្ញុំក៏សូមអនុញ្ញាតដាក់បង្ហាញនៅលើអេក្រង់ទូរទស្សន៍និងកុំព្យូទ័រផងដែរលោកប្រធាន
បាទជម្រាបអនុញ្ញាត
Mr. Witness, in
the
interview with the investigating judges, when you were being asked about one of these telegrams, which is telegram 54, you were asked the following question. Did you write this telegram by hand, or did you read it aloud for a typist to type? And your answer was, quote,I wrote it by hand and gave it to an encoder to put into numbers. Next, the encoder took it to a typist. Is this a correct statement of the process by which the telegrams that you sent were prepared?
Is this a correct statement of the process by which the telegrams that you
sent were prepared?
Where was the telegram office in Mondalkiri sector?
Mat, now, Kunong Kaw 17, Kulang Namban.
And who were the people at the telegram office who assisted you when you sent telegrams?
អ្នកខ្លះដែលនៅមន្ទីរទូរលេខហ្នឹងដែលបានជួយលោកក្នុងការបញ្ជូនទូរលេខហ្នឹងតើពួកគាត់ជាអ្នកណា
បាទគេអាខ្ញុំអត់ស្គាល់អ្នកណាទេខ្ញុំស្គាល់តែម្នាក់ដែលអ្នកបកសារហ្នឹងពីព្រោះខ្ញុំទៅមកកាន់កាប់ការងារថ្មីខ្ញុំនៅមិនទាន់ស្គាល់ពីណាស្គាល់តែអ្នកបកសារតែម្នាក់គាត់បាទ
How often did you send reports or telegrams to the leaders in Phnom Penh?
Yeah, tu to lake mau me dok nom neu Phnom Penh nang nyuk nyop pa na dae.
Ban at nyuk nyop te. So kal ma atit, so kal ka pi atit ta mdaong ka mien tang.
Mr. President, we would again like to submit a question to the witness regarding a prior statement, which is his, from his second interview with the investigating judges, which is document E3/383 at Khmer 00345913. English ERN 00350-264 and French ERN 00361-764. And again, we'd like to put that document on the screen.
764, ឲ្យខ្ញុំសូមបង្ហាញនៅលើអេក្រង់ទូរទស្សន៍និងកុំព្យូទ័រ
អញ្ញម្នាក់អនុញ្ញាត
Mr. Witness, in this statement that you gave to the investigating judges, you said as follows, quote, I had to report daily at least on rice production, climate, and how much or how little had been planted, end of quote. Do you confirm that this is an accurate statement,
Mr. Salsarum?
អញ្ជើញតំណាងនៅលោកមេវិការពីក្តីនោះជា
Thank you, Mr. President, and my apologies for interrupting. My objection does not have much to do with the actual subject matter of what we're discussing. There's more the technique of asking questions based on the statements before the co-investigating judges. The prosecutor has, in the past few questions, followed the line of reading out the statement before the co-investigating judges and then asking the witness whether that's a correct statement. And I think that does not tell us much. The witness has already indicated in the beginning of his appearance here before you that his statements before the investigating judges have been truthful, and I think it would be more useful to all the parties if the question would be phrased as, do you remember how this and this happened at the time, rather than just confirming the statement before the co-investigating judges, because I think that has very little added value. In this, on this particular topic, it may not matter much, but this will come back in the future. So it's a, I guess, a request to the prosecutor to phrase his questions in a slightly different way.
Mr. President, I appreciate the suggestion, but I would like to proceed in the manner that I have been, which is to first confirm that this is, the statement is correct, and then I have been doing what counsel suggests, which is to follow up and ask the witness some further questions about that. I think that's an appropriate way to proceed, and with your permission, I'd like to continue in that manner. Mr. Sausaroon, the statement that you made to the co-investigating judges indicating that you sent telegrams or reports daily, is that correct? Does that refresh your recollection that during 1978 you sent daily telegrams to the leaders of Phnom Penh?
ចុកកាល់ក៏ថ្ងៃចុកកាល់ក៏ពី3ថ្ងៃឬក៏មួយអាទិត្យម្ដងក៏មានបាទ
Mr. Sausaroon when you sentTelegrams to Phnom Penh. To whom did you address the telegrams when you sent them? Do you recall also sending telegrams that were addressed to Office
870?
Did you receive responses to the telegrams that you sent to Phnom
Penh? But ban to tool ka nai nom keu samkhan keu thoe srae thichaka pan nang ba
When you received responses with instructions, who was it that would send those responses? Do you remember, though, who it was, which persons sent you telegrams, sent you instructions in response to the telegrams that you had sent?
Mr. President, I'd like to read from the same interview as I did before, which is E3383, and the ERN site for this excerpt is Khmer 00345912, English ERN 00350263, and French ERN 00361763. If you may proceed and put that on the screen. Thank you. Mr. Witness, in your third interview with the investigating judges, you were asked the question, did you ever receive any responding telegrams? Who responded to those telegrams? The answer you gave was as follows, quote, senders from M870 included Nguyen Chea or Pol Pot. Sometimes they were addressed as M870, sometimes they were from Pol Pot, and sometimes they were from Nguyen Chea or Pol Pot. Do you confirm the accuracy of the statement today, Mr. Sasserum?
បាទខ្ញុំអត់បានបញ្ជាក់ទេគឺអានឹងចម្លើយនឹងគឺជាវាកាត្រឹមត្រូវបាទ
So the responses that you received to your telegrams sometimes were from Pol Pot, sometimes from Nguyen Chea, and sometimes from M870. Is that correct?
But, man, bit man, Jack, but.
And in the statement I just read, you referred to M870. Can you tell us what M870
was?
But I can't tell you what M870 was. តាំងតថាម៉ូត807ម៉ូត807យល់តែប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Well, I'd like to turn now to the first telegram that we're going to ask you about. Mr. President, it is document B3/248.And it is a January 1st, 1978 telegram from Sarun addressed to respected and beloved brothers of Office 870. And if we can put that on the screen, I will.Proceed as we have been doing, which is to read parts of it to the witness and then ask questions about that. Mr. Sasserun, in this telegram, which bears your name, Sarun, and the date of 1 January 1978, and is identified as Telegram 47 at the top, the telegram is addressed to respected and beloved brothers of Office 870. So, I would againlike to ask you that when you addressed a telegram to Office 870, who did you understand that you were sending this telegram to? Mr. President, I'd like to read the answer the witness gave to this question again in his second OCIJ interview, which is E3/383, and the ERN sites are Khmer ERN 00345912, English ERN 00350263, and French ERN 00361763. We may proceed with that on the screen also.
ហើយខ្ញុំសូមអនុញ្ញាតលោកប្រធានដាក់បង្ហាញនៅលើអេក្រង
់អង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាត
Mr. Witness, when you were asked about this telegram by the investigating judges, they asked the question, telegram 47 addressed respected brother M870. What does that mean? And the answer you gave was as follows, quote, M870 referred to the Central Committee that, as I remember, consisted of Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, Khieu Samphan, Son Sen, and Tamok. Do you confirm that this was a truthful statement by you, Mr. Sasserun?
អានឹងគឺជាការស្មោះត្រង់បានដូចបានជំរាបជូនលោកឆាក់ចៅក្រមបាទសូមអរ
Just so the record is clear, my colleague has told me there may have been a mistranslation, that M870 may have been translated as M78. So I think just so the record is clear, the question refers to M870. Am I correct, Mr. Witness, that you understood M870 to include a group of leaders from the Central Committee? Is that correct?
Is that correct? Is that correct? Is that correct? Is that correct? Is that correct?
បាទខ្ញុំបញ្ហានឹងខ្ញុំអត់យល់ទេបាទ
Do you recall who was on the Central Committee as of 1978? អ្នកណា
ខ្លះថិតនៅក្នុងគណៈមជ្ឈិមរបស់បកនៅឆ្នាំ1978នោះ
បាទខ្ញុំអត់យល់នឹងការងារខាងលើខ្ញុំអត់យល់
The telegram that we're discussing, the January 1st, 1978 telegram, is identified at the top as telegram 47. Can you explain to the chamber what that numerical reference meant, the indication of a number after of the telegram?
បាទខ្ញុំអត់ស្គាល់ទេគេចេះតែដាក់លេខអញ្ចឹងពីព្រោះខ្ញុំពីខាងបច្ចេកទេសខ្ញុំអត់យល់ចោះបាទ
Mr. President, I would like to read from the witness's interview, which is E3/383.Again, that's the second interview with the Khmer investigating judges at Khmer ERN 00-345-910-345-911, English ERN 00-350-262.And French ERN 00-361-762. And we'd like to put that on the screen.
Hi, some at Nyat Lukthien, the May Banghany, Aksani, the Lukthien, the Krong, the Tutu Pond, the Ahmad.
Oh, you're at Nyat.
Mr. Sasserun, in your interview with the investigating judges, when you were being asked about this telegram, you were asked the question, what was telegram 47 about? And you responded as follows, answer. It was the numerical order, a remark to be explained to the recipient, and it was also easy for us to refer to. Question, was the numerical order taken after a date or one number after another? And your answer was, the numbers ran from 1 to 100, for example. The number would return to 1. It would not go further than that. Do you confirm the testimony that you gave to the investigating judges? And is it correct that when telegrams were sent out, they would be numbered sequentially up until the number 100, at which time you would start over again at number 1? Is that correct? Now, turning back to the January 1, 1978 telegram, again, which is document E3/248, I would like to read to you the first paragraph of the telegram that you sent to Office 870 on the 1st of January, 1978. In that first paragraph, you said as follows, quote, we would like to report 9 Hmong people fleeing from their country. According to their interrogations, they said the Hmong had assigned them to come to spy inside Kampuchea and live with the Kampuchean people in order to grasp the Kampuchean people. Now we have swept them away. My first question is, who had provided you the information about the 9 Hmong people that you reported to Office 870 in this telegram? Did you receive reports from the sector military, which you then forwarded on to Office 870, Mr. Witness? Mr. President, I would again like to turn back to the witness's interview with the co-investigating judges, which is document E3/383, and the excerpt I would like to read is from Khmer 00345912, English ERN 00350263, and French ERN 00361763. Again, Mr. Witness, when you were
being asked about this telegram by the investigating judges, you provided the following testimony. Question. In telegram 47, what was the situation of Krang Te and Dak Dam like at that time? And what was it like after that? Your answer. At that time, I received reports from the sector army. Thus, I was not much aware of the situation. Question. Which military units had to report about the situation? Answer. Sector military had the right to report only to the sector committee. As for the center divisions, they had to report directly to the center. Do you confirm that the statement you provided to the investigating judges is true?
Yes,
So do I understand you correctly that you yourself did not have any direct involvement about in the matter relating to these 9-1 people, but the information had been reported to you by the sector military? Is that correct?
But
Who was it from the sector military that would report to you? Was it Ta
Sapia?
All right, Mr. President, I'd like to proceed to another telegram. And this telegram is document E3/1078. And it is a telegram dated 9 April 1978 from Sarun. This telegram number 46, and it is addressed to respected M870. And with your permission, we'd like to put that on the screen and ask some questions to the witness. Mr. Salsaroon, I'm going to ask you some questions now about another telegram, and in order for me to ask you the questions, I will first read for you the telegram that I'm going to be asking you about. It is a telegram to respected M870 that bears your name, Sarun, And it is telegram number 46. And the first paragraph reads as follows. On the night of 7 April 1978, there was a fire which destroyed two boats, 52 tanks of gasoline, 8 tanks of diesel, and a number of other tools. The cause of the fire was that the boat did not work. Upon arrival at Kampong Cham, our comrade requested another boat to tow the broken boat to Prek Prasab. Our comrade, who was the owner of the helping boat at Kampong Cham, went up to the village in order to find those who wanted to go down. There were three crew members on the boat. A crew member named Sang guarded on the head of the boat for fear that the people might use the lighter causing ignition, and two others named Eng Kat and Bun Sa were in the boat lighting a lamp. Meanwhile, the guard on the head of the boat warned them not to light the fire for fear of ignition of gasoline. Suddenly, there was flame of the ignited gasoline. The man holding the lamp was also injured. Well, let me stop there. This is in the middle of the telegram. Do you recall the incident of the boat setting on fire that is the subject of your telegram report? Do you recall that incident? I'd like to continue on and read the rest of your telegram, Mr. Sasaroon. The telegram continues as follows, quote, according to the sector's examination and the report of Comrade Sang, the two men had burned. The measures of the sector, one, arrest the two men, two, arrest contemptible lien. According to the examination, there had been the assignment from Lien. Carry out the arrest of these men today on the 9th with warmest revolutionary fraternity, Sarun, dated the 9th of April, 1978. The telegram indicates that the sector had conducted an examination of this matter. Who was it that had conducted this examination? When you wrote this telegram to Office 870, indicating as measures of the sector to arrest the two men and to arrest the contemptible lien, were you asking the party leaders in Phnom Penh for their decision on how to proceed, or were you informing them that you had already arrested these people? Why did you send this telegram to Office 870 proposing measures related to the rest of these people? What was your reason for sending this telegram to Office 870?
បាទគឺមានការខូចខាតអញ្ចឹងហើយរាយការណ៍ប៉ុន្តែគឺមិនបានចាប់បាទពីប្រុសសម្ភារៈក៏អស់មកចាប់មនុស្សទៀតកាន់តែខាតទៀតបាទ
Mr. Witness, who was it that had the authority to decide whether or not these people would be arrested? Was it you, or was it the people you were sending the telegram to at Office 870?
But I mean, the Chum Adang Tapinamian Amnai Te Pipro, John Tiang.អស់នឹងគឺមិនដែលបានចាប់នៅរស់ដល់សប្តាហ៍ថ្ងៃនេះបាទ
Did you receive a response to your telegram ឆ្លើយតបមកវិញ
ទៅនឹងទូរលេខរបស់លោកទេពេលដែលលោកផ្ញើទៅភ្នំពេញហើយ
បាទបើផ្ញើហើយគឺគេបានទទួលហើយគេតបមកវិញបាទ
And who was it that responded to this telegram?
ឆ្លើយតបមកវិញនោះ
បាទ លោកប៉ុលពត
And did he provide you instructions on what to do in relation to these people and his response
មនុស្ស2នាក់នេះនៅក្នុងដែលការឆ្លើយតបមកលោកវិញនោះ
បញ្ហានឹងដូចមិនឃើញមានសេចក្តីណែនាំទេពីព្រោះមនុស្សដែលសេះគ្រឿងសេះកណត់នឹងមិនដែលបានចាប់បានចងគេអញ្ចឹងសំភារៈវាខូចខាតហើយក៏យើងទៅមិនដែលណែនាំថាចាប់មិនដឹងណែនាំចងទេបាទអស់
Mr. President, if I may, this time read a short excerpt again from the second interview of this witness, E3/383. This excerpt is at Khmer 00-345-914, English ERN 00-350-265.And French ERN 00-361-765. We may also put that on the screen.
But how is some anya talaga na may banghain le ikrong panday man?
Ang jumre anya.
In your statement.To the co-investigating judges, Mr. Witness, about this telegram and the response you received, you made the following statement, quote, Pol Pot instructed not to arrest them, and I myself received the telegram from Pol Pot. Pol Pot instructed me to tell these three men not to be worried, end of quote. Is this a correct statement?
តើនេះជាចម្លើយត្រឹមត្រូវហើយនឹងដោយស្មោះត្រង់របស់លោកទេលោកសាក់សី
បាទអានឹងជាចម្លើយនឹងគឺជាការស្មោះត្រង
់ And is it correct then that in response to your telegram ឆ្លើយតបទៅនឹងទូរលេខរបស់លោកគឺលោកទទួលការណែនាំពីពលពតWhat to do about these men? Is that correct?
មនុស្សទាំងប្រមាណអ្នកនឹងតើអញ្ចឹងមែនទេ?
បាទ ត្រឹមត្រូវ. តើ បាទ ត្រឹមត្រូវហើយ ណែនាំ ប្រព្រឹត្តមិនអោយចាប់មិនអោយចងគឺអោយណែនាំគេអោយគេរស់នៅដោយសុវត្ថិភាពបាទ
Mr. Salsaroon,
Mr. Salsaroon,
We have an S-21 prisoner list titled Sector 105, which is document 175/3.15, which records that a Kong Lin, who was the assistant of Sector Commerce Office, was imprisoned at S-21 as of the 10th of June 1978. We also have a statement from the brother of Kong Lin confirming that he had worked in the Sector Commerce Office with Chun and that he was arrested following the boat fire incident that is the subject of your report to Office 870. Is it possible that your memory of this incident may be incorrect and that in actuality, in response to your telegram, Ankar decided to arrest Lin and to send him to S-21? Is it possible that your memory of this may be wrong?
But admin day, Kong Lin, you know the car, no poom, no rock, no subtle chapter. I got you, madam. You know,
we'd like to turn now to another telegram. Which is E3/156. And it is the telegram from the 23rd of April 1978 from Sarun, a too respected brother. And if we could display document E3/156 on the screen and request permission to ask some questions of this document to the witness. Mr. Sasarun, this is a telegram with your name from the 23rd of April 1978. It has three paragraphs, and I'd like to focus my questions on two of the paragraphs in the telegram. It is identified at the top as telegram 54. And in the second paragraph, let me read the second paragraph of the telegram to you before I ask you some questions. Quote,
thank you. Good morning, Mr. President. Maybe you can ask the question first, or maybe the prosecutor can ask this witness.
Mr. President, perhaps Mr. Pesman wasn't here. He may not realize the witness cannot see the documents anymore. He still was able to see at the time of his interview, and he did authenticate the documents in his interview, so that's why we have
to proceed this way. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to
realize that.
The second paragraph of the telegram that you sent on the 23rd of April 1978 reads as follows, quote, based on analysis, the division has agreed and wants to issue weapons to the sector forces to attack. Brother, what do you think? Please assist with your opinion, because previously there were complicated elements in the sector and they were all disarmed. If brother has any ideas, please report quickly. Do you recall sending a request for an opinion on whether or not weapons could be provided to people in the sector?
ចាំអរគុណលោកដំណាក់ថាបញ្ញាអរគុណសាក់សីឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសំឡំដំណាក់ហើយអញមិនប្រកាសសម្រាប់20នាទីចាប់ពីពេលនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង11:15នាទីទៅមកជើងចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដែងការមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលតុលាការត្រូវរួលផ្ដល់កន្លែងសម្រាប់ ដល់សាក់សីនឹងទីប្រឹក្សាសាក់សីនៅបន្ទប់រងចាំលោកអ្នកសាក់សីនឹងឲ្យអញ្ជើញគាត់មកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដល់ទឹកធ្លីកម្មវិញនៅវេលាម៉ោង 11:15 នាទីសម្រាប់ចុះ
សូមក្រុងជោគ